So I want to cut a circle out of the piece of acrylic that I've got here. This is actually from an old monitor. It's quite thick, probably about a quarter of an inch or so. Cutting circles, yeah, I could use something like a Tanco, but this wants to be a bit bigger than the 2 inches. The drill press with this ply cutter on there, or circle cutter on there, the most I can get is 4 inches, but you know, by the time I get clearance on the back of the stem, the actual diameter I can do is about 6 inches, but I want to do 10 inches. I could use a router, and with my router I've actually got one of these bars that's got a point on the end of it, and I could actually adjust the size of it, but you got to keep that point in the middle, and you've got quite a long swing area on here. This bar is actually 15 inches, so if I want to go for a 10 inch, that leaves me probably, let me get the router in there, 5 inches sticking out on the other side of the router. And I don't like the idea of that, because you've also got to hold the acrylic down steady so it doesn't move around, and that's going to be a bit awkward when you've got everything swinging around it. These fly cutters, they're okay. I would use it in the drill press. You've obviously got to be very careful that you don't get in the way of these arms as they swing around. I don't like using it handheld. This one was actually a bit longer than this. I shortened it so I can get it on the drill press, and for me that makes it a bit safer to use, because there's a lot of, you know, a lot of weight swinging around there. Another way I've done it in the past is I've got a table mounted router. And this is on the end of the saw bench. You can see the fence there for the saw blade. But what I've done, I've added a piece of wood on the end of the table, and that's so I can put the piece I'm cutting on the edge and put a screw through there. Obviously at times, you know, when you're using around about the same sort of dimension, you're going to get quite a lot of holes in the area, and eventually that piece of wood will need to be replaced. The other thing with this is it's very easy to twist it over by putting the weight in the wrong place while you're feeding it through. And I just don't like the idea of that, but it'd be far better if it was on the table itself. Now, I thought about using something on the guide slots to push it in and then lock it down, but that takes away from the depth of what you're trying to cut. You've already sort of lost a bit of depth by the thickness of the router table. And it, yeah, if you have too much depth, you've got to extend the router a bit, which makes it a bit unstable. So I got to thinking, there are other ways of doing this. As I said, I could use this bar, but you've got to hold it down. Same as, you know, when you make these wooden template pieces, that you can put a different hole in there. Again, you've got to hold this down without getting in the way of what you're doing, which means you've got to double stick it down to the base or something. So thinking about it, I'm thinking about, you know, these slots. Might be sort of useful. Come up with another idea. So this is the idea. It's only a piece of scrap wood, a piece of melamin paste chipboard. I've cut a slot in the middle, coming up towards the router bit, and there's a screw thread in there which adjusts the centre point. This is your pivot for rotating your piece around. You've got your router bit in there, and it's fairly fine thread, but you know, when you want to adjust it, you can always use a drill, and that way you can measure the distance, and once you've got it roughly where you want it, as I want to a 10 inch cut so I can actually hand spin that round now to get the right size. The pin in the middle, that's a 4mm screw in there. This middle one is a little bit higher so we can take the screw. These other two are quite low. And all they are is a couple of pieces of insulating material that I've had hanging around with a couple of holes drilled in. I've secured a little bush on the threaded rod and then jam two nuts on the end so that they don't get too much wobble. Now one of the things I like to do when I'm cutting a circle, especially if I want to make it fit, is cut it slightly large and then adjust it in a fraction to do a final trim cut, and possibly then it'll just be a case of sanding the edge just to do the final fit. So the advantage of this is that I've got the material on the top, it swings around quite nicely. Obviously you've got to be a bit careful about the scraping out, but yeah, you can either weld it in, JB weld it in or epoxy it in, or the good thing about having it in the middle like that is you can actually screw it down and tighten it onto the thread to lock it in position so you don't get vibrations spinning the thread. So I'm not sure what I want to do about that yet. Time will tell. If it starts unscrewing, then I'll just epoxy it in place so it doesn't come undone while I'm spinning this round. Talking about spinning round, those jigs where you use the bar type center point, one of the problems with that is when you're going round two or three times you're starting to twist the cable up. Again, that's something I don't like to do. So you go around once, then you untwist the cable and then go around again. And if you've got to do it three or four times, then that becomes a bit of pain. And this one, there's nothing to be twisted up. You've got full control of your material. And in this case, you can actually see what's going on. But there's enough room to see down the edge if it was a piece of wood, for instance. So that's it, that's the adjustment. As I say, I've got a piece of channel in there that was the basis of the slide, and then just cut a slot and screwed it down into the slot with another packer underneath to secure it to. So let's see this in action and see if it does the job that I want it to do. So there's the disc, and this is going to be for a rotary spark gap once I get a motor sorted out. I've got a couple of options I'm looking into at the moment, but yeah, I wanted something that was nice and large. But the other thing about doing this is I want to put some screw holes in there for the electrodes, and I can simply put the driver on the end. Got to clear out the mess. Now I can decide where I want the holes, how far away from the edge I want, and I can raise the router through to at least mark the positions fairly accurately, and away we go. Something that you might want to consider building the micro adjust circle cutting jig.